In today's episode, we'll talk about, in my opinion, the best show streaming on Netflix. What's up, everyone? It's Michael with the Nation 80 Podcast, and today I want to talk to you about Arcane League of Legends and why you should be watching it. First, if you haven't already, go ahead and hit that subscribe button so you don't miss out on our latest episodes, and at the end of the video, smack the like button so we can continue to bring you more content in the future. All right, so let's get into it. So Arcane League of Legends debuted on November 6th and runs about 9 episodes. This show is an adaptation of the popular online game with the same name, League of Legends. So this game is a multiplayer battle arena game, a game that I've never actually played. I don't really play those types of games, but I was interested in the story because the show is basically based off of the characters from that game. This show is a collaboration between Riot Games and Fortish Production, which mainly handles most of the art and animation. It was created and developed by Alex Yi and Christian Link, who have been part of the League of Legends team for over 10 years and were part of the original team behind the main characters Jinx and Vi. I've only seen the first 3 episodes, but I can definitely tell you what this show is about. So the story explores the complex relationships between the characters from the games, most particularly from sisters Violet and Jinx. In the background, you have 2 cities. You've got Piltover, which is your more advanced technology, you're rich, you're educated, and then you have Zaun, which is more of your underground, your people trying to scrape by. And it's kind of that classic tale of classism of the haves and have-nots. Now, in this first arc, we really get to see the introduction of these characters and what their current situation is. And we see that Violet and, at the time, Powder, which is aka Jinx, are trying to pull heists, make money for Zaun and their family and friends. And you have them stealing and being chased down by the police all the way down into the undergrounds of their city. And so you also get introduced to the leaders of each city and their struggle to maintain the peace. But then you also get a sort of a side story where you have science and technology clash or mysticism. Whereas in Zaun, you're introduced to a character, Victor, who is using drugs and chemistry to create these monsters to sort of take over the Piltover way of life. And then on the other side, you have Joyce, or Jace, who is trying to develop and merge magic and technology, which he calls Hex Tech, and improve the quality of life of Piltover. All right, so let's talk about the cast. All right, we already know that we have Violet and Jinx, and they're the main centerpiece of this story. But there are plenty of other characters that you should be paying attention to. So let's start with Vi. She's played by Hailee Steinfeld. If that name sounds familiar, you've seen her on Disney Plus playing as Kate Bishop on the new Hawkeye TV show. There's also Powder, who's played by Ella Purnell. She was from the Army of the Dead. And then there's, and actually when I say Powder, she's Jinx as an adult. But Young Powder is played by Maya Sinclair. And you also have Victor, who plays this guy who is the one who's using chemistry and mysticism or magic and whatever other technology to create these monsters. He's played by Harry Lloyd from A Brave New World. Then you've also got Jace from the Piltover side of the city, who's played by Kevin Alejandro, which you may know is from Lucifer. Then you have Vander, played by John Benoit Blanc. He's from War Dogs. And then you have Caitlin, Katie Leung, who's from Harry Potter. She played one of Harry Potter's love interests in those movies. All right, so let's talk about impressions from this show, because as I mentioned before, I've only seen the first three episodes, but these first three episodes were such a kicker for me that I wanted to get this video out and get you all to notice what this show was about and why you should watch it. All right, so let's talk about the artistic style or the visual style. I love it when shows take a risk and try to create something that draws you in that's not a part of the mainstream style. And I feel like this show does that. So when we talk about the artistic style, they have kind of a mix of painted, 3D modeling, and 2D effects. And that's mainly from Fortiche. And so I really kind of think of this as sort of the route that you got from Clone Wars or from Rebels from Star Wars, and that kind of artistic style where they had these great, simple but detailed character models, these 3D models, but they had these beautifully drawn, beautifully painted backgrounds. And that's what you're getting here in Arcane. You got these really nice, simple but very detailed 3D models that can really show the emotion of these characters. And then in the background, whether it's the cities or certain scenes from these cities, you've got these beautifully drawn backgrounds. And what's doubly cool is that they didn't use any motion capture. What they did was do everything by hand. You got the motion capture, you got these detailed characters. It really makes a great environment for this show. But it's not just about the art. It's not just about the style that they went with. It's also about the sound design and the musical score that really draw you into the environment and give you this sense of emotion and danger. It you can see they really paid attention to the sound design for this Netflix series. And it just, along with the artistic value, the artistic style, and the sound, it just draws you into that environment. But all this wouldn't really be possible if you didn't have great voice acting, if you didn't have great dialogue between the characters. And all of it is top-notch. And that's not only a credit to the actors, but a credit to the writing. Like, it really just brings you in. It really gets you involved. It's not a show that is super heavy on action, but it's a show that when the action does happen, there are consequences, and it makes you worried for what's happening to the characters. And so as you can see, I keep talking about characters. There's not a whole lot of world building, as the show really focuses more on development of these people in this story. So as I explained before, without giving too much away, the first story arc of this show centers around the struggle between the people of both cities. You know, you've got the Piltover people who are trying to improve quality of life and are basking in their fortune and their technology and just living a good life, whereas you have the people of Zaun who are struggling. They are people that have been beat down. The opening scene is intense. Again, there's not a lot of action, but the action that there is shows you what the struggle is all about, and they seem like a very oppressed people, and they're just trying to make their life, make their living. And this show, at least the first story arc, is about the give and pull between both cities. And so you have that, and then you have this mysterious hex tech that's being developed by Jace, and maybe there's good consequences, maybe there's bad consequences. We really don't know. Don't mind my cell phone that just went off. But these first three episodes, in each three episodes is a story arc, so that's pretty cool. But what we have here is a show, at least in the beginning, is something that really pulls you into what life could be like for ones that are looking for a better tomorrow, or ones that are looking for not to just be treated equal and to have an opportunity, a chance to make a living for themselves. So why should you watch this show? Arcane League of Legends scores a perfect 100% on Rotten Tomatoes, with an IMDb score of 9.1. And while I'm not the kind of guy to just listen to critics and Rotten Tomato score, it's pretty impressive that it got 100%. And I like looking at IMDb because that's you, that's the people talking. And to get a 9.1, that's pretty intense. Riot Games knocked it out of the park with their attempt to bring characters to life in this engaging series that explores the complicated relationships in an ever-changing world. And it's something that you can relate to, especially in today's world, where you might feel marginalized. You might feel like you're in a situation where you're just trying to make your way, and maybe in your neighborhood or in your city, you have the people that have everything, and you feel like you don't have anything, and you're just trying to make your own way in life. Whereas on the flip side of it, you might be a person who may not have everything, but has the opportunity to create, to discover, to explore new technology, new science, or anything like that. And it's a very relatable story, and I'm really glad that Riot Games were able to come out with this show. I, for one, will be looking, salivating to watch the rest of the series. I believe they already got renewed for a second season. So when that happens, I will for sure do a review of the entire season. But for now, go ahead and watch Arcane League of Legends on Netflix. Okay, so that'll wrap it up for this episode. I really hope you enjoyed this video, and I really hope that you check out this show, Arcane League of Legends, on Netflix. I really think it's something worth watching, especially since we've had some disappointment with some other shows that were hyped and that came out. Cowboy Bebop. And so I hope that you check it out. If you haven't already, go ahead, hit that subscribe button. If you really enjoyed this video, hit the like button as well. Be sure to check out more upcoming content. Be sure to check out Rodney's videos as he keeps posting gameplay footage of popular games such as Cyberpunk and Avengers. And we're coming up on the holidays, or we're here on the holidays. And so we look to be posting some more videos of getting some gift ideas for the nerd in your life. So it's Michael, your host from the Nation 80 podcast. Enjoy your day and keep imagining, keep reading, and we'll catch you in the next one.